Welcome to Miniature Scene. Today we will be assembling a workstation. The workstation is a custom and portable work area. Great for people who are tight on space or just like to keep all their builds organized. Once you have finished your build for the day, you can just put the workstation on top of your fridge or any other high area. Great for keeping out of the way of the kids. Everything will be as you left it when you come back to it. The workstation comes with a choice of modules that you can choose the layout for your own requirements. Four modules choices are shelf, tubs, paint rack, and dropper rack. The shelf comes with a device holder and a hidden drawer. The tubs or bit storage are a two-tiered stack and they have removable walls, great for all those tiny little parts. And the paint rack holds 18 paints up to 33mm in diameter, which is including the latest Citadel pots and the P3 paints. The dropper rack is ideal for the skinnier bottles that are 26mm in diameter. You can store the bottles either way up and it holds up to 28 bottles. The base section has a samurai style brush and tool holder, and the final choice required is what coloured cutting mat you should choose. The colours are pink, blue, green, purple, black. If you can't make up your mind, then you can choose random on your order and we'll roll a dice to decide for you. Now let's get to assembling the workstation. I have here the shelf-shelf combo with a purple mat. To get started, you will need some PVA glue and of course a workstation. You may also want to use a hobby knife and some sandpaper. Alright, so first we take off the plastic. We also have all the instructions available online. Ready to get started. We are going to open up the base. Alright, so with our base, we have various pieces. Now when assembling these, you can have either a nice side up or the burnt side up. Ideally, the burnt side goes on the bottom or at the back of things. Nice side up. These things. You have to be careful here that you don't glue it into your table. Put a little bit around the edges. Actually, I'll put this underneath it so I don't glue it to my table. Good thing about PVA is you've got a few seconds to make it right. These little locks. Nicely, got it in the right spot. Just lock. On the floor. Then we add this piece at the back. Should, if you've got it nice. fit in nice and snug. This will hold all your modules together. Excess glue, just the wet rag or something like that. Me and the base bits, just this bit and all the inner bits. This is so it fits the cutting mat properly. Start assembling the shaft. We'll do left first. Now, if you suddenly get these and you decide you want to go the other way and pull whatever you want, if you can build them upside down, it will give you the same thing, it'll just be a bit smokier. And for the workstation, it doesn't matter too much. So, take off this plastic. This piece here, that's the last remaining piece of our base. That's for our samurai brush and tool holder, so we'll do that one at the end. First piece is this one, pop it down. Stability, so just fall down. Dog keeps trying to come inside with bones, and I keep telling it to not have bones inside. So I'm gonna have to get that off her in a second. There we go. Face it. I didn't put it on as I was doing it. So this piece here, line all these up nicely. Also, to be patient to let it dry, Final bit for our shelf is to make the drawers. Secret drawer. Bottom is my secret. With that module, this is the left hand side you will sit. This one. And of course, we've got the white solders, which I will do later. That's the control. Let's put this. Simmer in to brush holder. Don't have any brushes on at the moment, you can put your tools in on that. So voila! One last little pop of these. And watch that. Put the tablet like device. Adjust your things, and you can put the phone in like so. If you want a little bit more stability, put the handles on. They're up next to the shelves part, and just slide in. Stick a drawer, goes in the back. And because I have a shelf shelf, I'm to leave, slide in. Yeah. Secret papers. Voila, we're finished. So with PVA glue, it's recommended to leave it dry for about 24 hours before you start playing with it. It's touch dry after about 20 minutes, but to be really solid to get a firm thing, you need about 24 hours on it. Leave it dry and it's all good. I'm gonna finish my other secret box that I have here and my other device holders. All right, thank you for tuning in. If you have any ideas of which ones you want me to build next, let me know.